running Photoshop and get messages like this, this, or this? What is Scratch this and what can we do about it? That's the topic we are going to talk about today. You have got Scratch Disk full message in Photoshop and you don't know what it is and what we can do about it. Before I jump into the solution, we need to know what is a Scratch Disk. A Scratch Disk is a disk drive or SSD used for temporary storage while Photoshop is running. Photoshop uses this space to store portion of your documents and their history which don't get fit in RAM's memory. So why do we get Scratch Disk full message? The most common cause of getting this message is simply lack of storage space available in the Scratch disk. So let me show you this chart here to explain you what is Scratch disk and how it works. So let's suppose this is the primary drive where the Photoshop is installed and we call it the Scratch disk. So basically what happens when you install your operating system, it takes some space into your hard drive or SSD. So we call it operating system. And then secondly, once you launch Photoshop, it takes much this space. So even when you launch Photoshop, you haven't opened any document yet, it takes away this much space in your hard drive. This chart is for illustration purposes only to make you understand what is a Scratch disk and how it works. And once you create a new document or open an existing PSD file in Photoshop, let's suppose this takes away this much space. And we call it Photoshop running documents. So you see this much space has been taken already in the hard drive even before editing any documents in Photoshop. So you see this gray area on a side. So basically this is the free space. Now if you perform any edits in Photoshop, this running document can take up all the space depending how intensive or large documents you are working on. So what happened when all the space available is full? This is where you get this message. So here we have two solutions for it. So the first solution is we can provide more Scratch disk space to Photoshop where it can accommodate all those extra temporary documents and our edits will go along smoothly. So how can we do that? Just go to Edit, Preferences and Scratch disk. And if you are Mac users, your option will be Photoshop and Preferences. So here you can see I have this much space available, 64.91 gigabytes available in my C drive where my Photoshop is installed. And then I also have added my second disk where almost 549 gigs are available for the Scratch disk. So basically what happened, if the C drive gets full and then the Photoshop will take space from the E drive. So I have more than enough space available for Photoshop to perform all those tasks and it can handle large files easily. And if you do not have more space available on the other drives or do not have any external drives, so this brings up to our second solution, which is to remove all unnecessary files and create more space with our existing drives. So how do we do that? So I'm going to press cancel. So in order to create more space, we have to remove unnecessary file or move the file, existing file, to external hard drive. So if I was you, I will be looking after for disk cleanup options. You can Google it and you will find all the ways how it works. And then empty the recycle bins. If you have removed something from your computer, but it is still sitting in the recycle bin or trash, it is still taking space in your hard drive. So get rid from all those trash or all those recyclable items and clear it, and you get more space available on the C drive. And the second thing I would do, I will take away or remove all those temporarily file which Photoshop use to run this document. So I go to Edit and I go to Purge and I will remove all the clipboards. So whatever documents or whatever data you have copied from somewhere, you wanna paste here, will be removed, so it will give you more space on your disk. I will clear all of this option, but once you do that, you will lose access to all the history and all the undos on your running document. So in this case, I am not worried about losing the history, so I will make sure I will press go to edit and go to purge and press all. And this way, this cannot be undone and continue, yes. And it will create more space for Photoshop to use. And the third most important thing I would do is to remove the temporarily file from the scratch disk. So basically what happened, every time you open Photoshop, Photoshop takes away this much or any space in the hard drive. And when you close the document or when you close the Photoshop, it doesn't mean all this space which Photoshop used will get back to normal. So basically what happens, sometimes Photoshop leaves those large temporary files unattended in the temporary folder. So we need to clean those temporary files from time to time to make more space available for the Photoshop. And let me show you how can we locate those temporary files. So I'm using Windows. If I open my computer, so in my computer I have installed Photoshop in C drive where I have 65 gigabytes free space available. So in order to remove the temporary file, I need to go to C drive or the drive where you have installed the Photoshop, open up, and then we need to go to users. So in my case I will select this one, and I'm using Windows 10. And for Windows 10 user, you make sure you go to view and then click on this hidden items, because the folder I'm looking for here is hidden and you won't be able to see it if you don't have this hidden items check on. So once you check the hidden item on, so here's the app data I'm looking for. So simply click on the app data and then go to local, and here I'm looking for a folder called temp. So if I open up this folder, you see all these files are here are temporary file which has been created by Photoshop time to time. And if I select all by pressing Ctrl A and right click on this and go to the properties, and you will see, oh my god, look at this. So Photoshop has taken 40 gigabytes, almost 40.4 gigabytes space from my hard disk for all those temporary files which are completely useless for me now. So I press cancel and select all and right click on any of them and select delete, and it will delete all the files. So these files are still there. Let me check what's the size of it. So these are 22 MB, which is not a lot. So if I go back to my computer, and now you can see by removing those temporary files which was almost more than 40 GB in size, my I have got 105 GB free space available in my C drive now. And if you are using Mac, you need to go to go menu and need to press option key from the keyboard, and then you will see libraries, and in libraries you need to go to application support, Adobe, Common, Media Cache, and you see all those files which you can find in Media Cache. You can remove all those files. These are all temporary files, you don't need it. And make sure you can see the path on the screen now. Make sure you follow this path, and whichever file you see in these locations, you need to remove them all, because those all are temporary files. And another thing you need to pay attention to, if we are using other Adobe softwares like Adobe Premiere Pro or Adobe After Effects, you must have some sort of cache memories in those drives, and make sure you go there and remove all those temporary files. I hope this tutorial helped you in some ways, and if it did, make sure you click the like button. And if you are here on my channel first time, please do consider subscribing, because this channel is all about Photoshop. Photoshop tricks, tips and new tutorials you will get all the times, and if you hit the bell icon you will get all the notifications. And if you have any question or comment related to this tutorial, please feel free to drop the line into the comment section. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye now.